Chineke, odiro ye dika. Call that name Jesus, Jesus, and wave your hand to him, bless him, magnify this great, great God. Let's give him all the glory, all the praise, all the honor. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we praise your name. We magnify you. We give you praise and glory. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have worship. With Jesus' joy and with great excitement, let's welcome to the microphone Pastor G. Lawal to lead us in the opening prayer for the ordination service of deacons and deaconesses in this annual convention of the year 2015.
Olorun to da won oke igba ni eyin ni mo fi ọpẹ mi fun Ọlọrun
Ọlọrun so da wa oke yi ga ni eyin mo fi ọpẹ
ni wo tun gbega o
bi ko se baba lo sa ni wo tun fi ko ope mi fu Ọlọrun so da wa oke yi
Let us raise our two hands up and say, Father, we thank you. We shall be very ungrateful if we cannot be able to appreciate our God. This is another convention. Last year, we are here without any problem. Let's thank him for the miracle of sleeping and waking up. Many people slept yesterday. They could not be able to wake up. It's not because we are better off, but because of his mercy. Lord Almighty, we give all the praises and adoration. Let's thank him. He's worthy of our praises. He's worthy of our adoration. is the one that can do all things. It's the all-sufficient God. He's the one that can never fail. Let's appreciate Him. Almighty God. Let's thank Him. Worship Him for what He has done for the past 1 year. Let's thank Him because the church of God is still marching on. Let's thank Him for the peace that is reigning in this country. Let's thank Him because we are not in the hideout today. Let's bless the name of the Lord. Thank Him because you are God. We will appreciate you. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. And so, Father, we thank you because you are God. We cannot thank you enough. Thank you for the past annual conventions. Thank you for all the programs. Thank you for salvation. Thank you for healing. Thank you for deliverance. Thank you for everything that you have done so far. Father, Lord, I say thanks in the mighty name of Jesus. Father Almighty, we thank you for sleeping and waking up. We thank you because we can go to the toilet by ourselves and unite by ourselves. Thank you for the provision. Thank you for protection. Thank you for everything. Lord Almighty, I say thanks in the mighty name of Jesus. Today, in the beginning of a new thing, Lord, begin with us afresh in the mighty name of Jesus. Let there be salvation galore. Let there be healing galore. The theme of the convention is the all-sufficient God. Lord, you are the one that can send help to us. In four corners of the world, send help to us in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever our destiny may be, send them to us in the mighty name of Jesus. Take control of this convention. Let your power, let it be manifested in this place in the mighty name of Jesus. Your son that you are going to use today, Father, endow him with a fresh anointing in Jesus' name. Lord Almighty, at this junction we commit our Father unto you. He has no power of his own. Send him the more in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your mighty hand from above, let it touch him in the mighty name of Jesus. We commit our mother unto you. Lord Almighty, strengthen her also in the mighty name of Jesus. They be running ether scattered. Don't let them be weary. Don't let them be tired. Father, strengthen them. Thank you because we are God. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. You may be seated.
Let somebody shout hallelujah. The one whose life is going to change permanently for the better from now, shout hallelujah. Well, those of you who are to be ordained as deacon and deaconesses, congratulations. Well, as there are more than 9,000 of you, we expect that things will move very fast because those who are going to help me in lay hands on you are ready and are prepared. So please just follow the direction of the ushers and go straight to where they ask you to go, and please stay very close together before you kneel down, and then the work can continue. So straight away now, you can begin to go. Follow the ushers. I believe they are already there. And please make sure you are very close together so that my special assistants who will help me lay hands on you will be able to do the job as quickly as possible. Yeah, we can have worship hymns as the people begin to move. Beginning straight away. God bless you. The rest of you, as you come, make sure you are very close together before you kneel down. As soon as you are very close together, go on your knees, as the ordination had already started. Okay.
Pilar. Believe that I
We ordain you deacons and deaconesses in the Redeemed Christian Church of God in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Almighty God Himself will overshadow you. The Holy Spirit will be your strength. From now on, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Whatever you ask to come will come. Whatever you ask to go will go. You will not fail. You will not fall. God will use you for His glory. And in the kingdom of God, you will not be missing. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God bless you. Congratulations. You can go back to your seats now. And let the next set come in very quickly. And please, my assistants, as soon as the first row has lined up, begin to walk quickly on them. We have quite a crowd here this morning. Okay, you go back to your seats very quickly and let the next set come in. God bless you.
Here we are, lifting our hands to you. Here we are, giving you thanks, giving you thanks for all you do. As we pray
and
worship your holy name,
you are here,
dwelling within our prayer. Thank you.
Father, you are great. Father, you
We ordain you deacons and deaconesses in the Redeemed Christian Church of God in the name of the Father,
Amen.
And of the Son,
Amen.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Almighty God Himself will overshadow you.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit will be your strength. From now on, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth will be loose in heaven. Whatever you ask to come will come. Whatever you ask to go will go. You will not fail. You will not fall. God will use you for His glory. And in the kingdom of God, you will not be missing. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. Congratulations. You can go back to your seats. And then the next set can come in very quickly. And we continue as before.
Yes, you are alone, most times. Yes, you are alone, most times. Yes, you are.
Yes, you are the Lord.
Yes, you are the Lord.
Most high.
Church of God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Almighty God Himself will overshadow you. The Holy Spirit will be your strength. From now on, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you lose on earth will be loose in heaven. Whatever you ask to come will come. Whatever you do, you will not fail. You will not fall. God will use you for His glory. In the kingdom of God will not be found missing.
It belongs to the Almighty God. But as we confess it, as we say it from our hearts, we move from the level of affirmation to the level of revelation. Revelation is when God Himself speaks to your heart that the earth really belongs to Him. So let's say it again. The earth is the Lord's. Let's say it with expectation. The earth belongs to you. Help us, Lord Almighty, at this hour. In your mercy and grace, according to your compassion and power, help us, every one of us, help us, O God. At this moment, let there be the mark of the global grace upon us, the mark of the global anointing upon us, upon every one of us. This set, O God Almighty, that you have brought together, Lord of hosts, who made heaven and earth, let your hand be upon these your people, upon every one of us, that the mark of the global unction might be made manifest in us and through us in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for hearing us. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. You may be seated, please. Let's shout that phrase one more time. The earth is the Lord's. Hallelujah. If we have a real revelation, there is none that steereth up himself to take a hold on God. So it's an opportunity that no matter what we had been doing before, no matter how we had been operating, now we are given an opportunity to come before God and for the hands to be laid upon us, for us to be consecrated to Him, set apart, licensed to operate for Him. And with that kind of opportunity, we can say, Lord, I come back to you completely to fulfill the purpose for which you created me. The earth is yours. I come back to you that this unction that can take me all around the earth will function in my life. Today, I'm expecting someone to receive a special activation of what I call the global anointing and receive it in the name of Jesus Christ. That your eyes will go just beyond your local privilege. And you will know that this earth belongs to God. The Redeemed Christian Church of God was set up by God for the whole world. And you are partner in this. Therefore, your vision has to cover the whole world. The Lord grants you the mark, the grace of the global anointing in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord grant you that from today, in a special way, it will be a turning point in your life. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of the one who made heaven and earth. You see, the global service and global ministry is a possibility for you. It's a possibility for every one of us. But there comes a time in a man's life when God, in a special way, touches that person. And the person's life is turned around and a new beginning comes forth. And that which is mere possibility becomes reality. May the global ministry turn from possibility to reality in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. May the Lord of hosts make today a special day in your life, a day you will never forget, a day of change, a day of a new dimension. A day that you can see the world. You see the world changing. A day you can see the will of God being implemented on earth, even as it is done in heaven. And let it be so in your life, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's say that phrase again. The earth is the Lord's. Please say it loud. The earth is the Lord's. One more time. The earth is the Lord's. Yes, this earth belongs to God. I'm sure that you all have this outline. I'm not going to follow it step by step. I'm not going to read everything in it because you already have it. So you'll be able to read it at home. I suggest that you study it, digest it. It took many weeks to write up the little thing that you see here. So I will just comment on some other lights that God put in my heart as I went through that material. And I will refer to the scroll that I'm talking about wherever I have the opportunity to do that. But the burden in my heart is that today is a turning point in somebody's life. That somebody from today will look beyond himself and look outward and see that the earth is the Lord's. That from today, somebody will see that he has been called by the Almighty God to be a minister who will influence the whole globe. Somebody say, I receive it in the name of Jesus. Say it again, I receive it in the name of Jesus. So in the introduction, I just want to remind us of a few things. Just to remind us of one or two things. I want to remind us of the fact that since the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, what God wants us to identify with is the kind of heart that he has towards the earth. For God so loved the world, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. When we identify with God that the earth is the Lord's, John 3:16 will begin to burn in our hearts and burn in our bones. When John 3:16 burns in your heart and burns in your bones, you will not only say it that the earth is the Lord's, but you will live it. It will affect your attitude. It will affect your language. It will affect your lifestyle. It will form habits in your life that will rule your life. Because God loved the world and has translated this love into your heart that nobody should perish. The earth is the Lord's. The people therein belong to him. We identify with God. We are his co-workers. May the Almighty God separate you specially from today in the name of Jesus Christ. And may John 3:16 burn like fire in your heart and burn like fire in your bone. In the name of Jesus Christ, may the Lord help us to be totally committed to his will, his absolute will on the earth, that his will might be done on earth as it is done in heaven. The Redeemed Christian Church of God is part of God's game plan in establishing his will on earth, because the earth is the Lord's. And because it is the Lord wants his will to be done fully on earth. The Redeemed Christian Church of God is part of God's master plan. His master plan to reach the whole world. and you are privileged to be part of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, and to be ordained today, to be licensed today, to be significantly identified today as someone who is authorized to operate fully in the Redeemed Christian Church of God. You are part of God's plan. May the Lord make you a global figure. The Lord of hosts make you a global figure. The Lord of hosts make you a global figure in the name of Jesus Christ. Because you are part of a global vision. Being part of a global vision, what you are even doing in your locality can become a global of global impact. These days, someone doesn't have to travel around the whole world to impact the world. You can stay in your bedroom, in your sitting room, and be impacting the whole world. You can go on the internet, a simple thing, and it becomes viral. It goes all over the place, affects all the people who listen to it, spreads the anointing all over the place. The Almighty God make you a global figure. Jehovah make you a global figure. In the name of Jesus. There is nothing that is too difficult for God. Nothing at all. And because you have been ordained today, you are now in the driver's seat. There is responsibility that you must bear. Like in the introduction, the third scroll in the introduction. You see, everyone ordained in the RCCG is licensed to facilitate the knowledge of God and the gospel harvest on earth. You are licensed to facilitate it. People need to know God. You are authorized to make it easy for people. You're authorized to make it happen. God has chosen you as a vessel to establish his will, both in your locality and at a global level. Receive it in the name of Jesus Christ and let it work in your life from today. In the name of Jesus. Somebody say, the earth is the Lord's. The earth is the Lord's, and I am a global figure. I am a global figure. The earth is the Lord's. I am a global figure. As you confess it, you receive it, and you will live it in the name of Jesus Christ. It will become part of your life, part of the manifestation of your life in the name of Jesus. The last scroll under the introduction, the real challenge in my heart there that I want to share with us is that John 10:10 demands that we do our best. The Lord Jesus came that we might have life and that we might have it more abundantly. He came that our neighbors might have life and have it more abundantly. Jesus came that our family members might have life and have it more abundantly. And you've been licensed and put in the driver's seat that you are supposed to play the role to facilitate it, to ensure that God in his mercy and grace touches the lives of your friends, your children, your neighbors, your siblings, your church members, everyone around you, that we might have that life abundantly. The devil comes to steal, to kill, to destroy. But we thank God that Jesus is far superior to the devil. The power of the devil is no power compared to the superpower of the Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, God has chosen you that by his grace and mercy, that people might have life and have it more abundantly. The earth is the Lord's. This vision is to spread all over the earth. Your vision must spread all over the earth. People must live according to the standards of God. The Lord use you in the name of Jesus Christ. We go to section A. Section A has got to do with the vision. If we are thinking about being global figures, then we must understand the vision and be committed to the vision. The vision that God Almighty has set before us. Vision demands consecration. Where God gives a revelation, what he is calling for is consecration. If God shows you something, he wants you to get committed to it. So vision demands consecration. And anybody who understands this vision, that the earth is the Lord's, the earth is the Lord's, anyone who has an understanding of it, submits to consecration. We'll return back to God. We'll notice that the earth is so big, is so great, is so much. How much can we contribute to it? But our contribution becomes significant as we turn back to the Almighty God who made the heaven and earth. The earth is the Lord's. It is the Lord's. And as we turn back to the Lord who made heaven and earth, the Lord uses us and makes us a blessing on the earth and throughout the whole earth. The Lord God Almighty help you and use you in the name of Jesus Christ. Any minister in the Redeemed Christian Church of God that is not committed to the global vision is short-sighted. And I'm going to give you several reasons for this. The vision of the Redeemed Christian Church of God is a global vision. The vision of the Lord Jesus Christ that made him give us the mandate to go into all the world is a global vision. The vision of the Redeemed Christian Church of God is a global vision. You are ordained into a global vision today. And the globe, you must see. That's what you need to see. We need to see beyond ourselves. When we see more of what God has chosen us to do, then we have less time for a lot of the trivialities that consume our time and consume our energies and consume our finances and consume all our resources. Let's focus on what God really called us to. The Redeemed Christian Church of God is a global vision. It's a global vision because the earth is the Lord's. It's a global vision. It's a vision given by God for the globe. You have been brought into it. So whether you like it or not, for accepting this ordination, you're already in it. There is no escape. The Lord will help you. The Lord Almighty will help you. Because as I'm saying it, I know you need help. So the Lord help you. The Lord help you in this global vision. The Almighty God help you in this global vision. In the name of Jesus. In scroll number 2, we need to unplug our inner ears. Some of us are hard of hearing. We can't hear the real things that God is saying. Maybe because we are hearing so much of CNN, we are hearing so much of Fox News, we are hearing so much of channels. We need to hear God. In fact, just imagine it as if God has a postcard or even a poster, a very big billboard that is spreading all over around this hall for all of us to see. And what is written on it is wanted. Wanted. The first wanted has one exclamation mark. The second wanted has two exclamation marks. Wanted. The third one has three exclamation marks. Wanted. Vessels committed to the global vision of God. The global vision of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. That's what God is looking for. That's what he's looking for today. And as we pray, even before we pray, as the word comes forth, anyone who will receive it, our mentality changes. Our thinking pattern changes. And let's remember that as a man thinks in his heart, that's actually how the man is. And there is nothing that changes our mentality as much and as quickly as having a revelation of the word of God. The Lord says to us today, the earth is the Lord's. The earth is the Lord's. The earth is the Lord's. As you're being ordained, he's saying, the earth is the Lord's. The earth is the Lord's. As you leave this place, he's saying, the earth is the Lord's. The earth is the Lord's. Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel. The Lord Almighty help us and unplug our inner ears in the name of Jesus Christ. He says, he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying to the churches. May the Lord help us to hear him. Anybody who hears God has heard all that is important. May the Lord help you as a person to hear him in the name of Jesus Christ. In scroll 3, I want us to think again about what God told Papa Akindayomi. Let's think again about it. That God spoke to him when there was no sign whatsoever about what we have even seen in our time. That he's establishing the Redeemed Christian Church of God to go round the whole world, to be in every nation of the world, and that the Redeemed Christian Church of God will remain until the Lord Jesus Christ comes back. You have been ordained today to get back to the foundation. The very foundation is a revelation that God gave to Papa Kidayomi. Let's listen to him. Let's imagine that God gave him the opportunity to say, what do you have to say to us today? I suspect that what he will say is, the earth is the Lord's. Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel. May the Lord God unplug our inner ears in the name of Jesus Christ. May the Almighty God help you as a person and help me also in the name of Jesus, because he is Lord forever. Okay, let's think about Daddy Adeboye. Let's think about his heart. Think about his attitude. Think about his desires. Think about the targets that he has given to us. The whole thing is made simple in the vision statement and the mission statement of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. I want to make heaven. I want to take as many people as possible there. We want to plant churches within reach of everywhere that the Lord God Almighty sends you to. The Lord Almighty help us to fulfill this in the name of Jesus Christ. The vision is global. That's all we are saying. That what you are called to is a global vision. That the earth is the Lord's. The earth does not belong to any president. It does not belong to any prime minister. The earth is the Lord's. It belongs to God. And God is sending us all over the earth. From our vision statement, from our mission statement, from the targets that Daddy has given to us, the earth is the Lord's. The earth is open. Please embrace it. See yourself beyond where you are. You are much bigger than you look outside. If you are carrying the rivers of living water, you are so much bigger than what you look outside. Those rivers are supposed to flow and flow and flow and water the whole earth. The Almighty God use you around the world in the name of Jesus Christ. In scroll number 5, even if all these things don't motivate you, at least let the results touch your heart. Let the fact that already Redeemed Christian Church of God is present in over 180 countries of the world. This thing is a global vision. That's what I'm standing here to say. And I'm saying it in as many ways as possible until you can hear it. You just got to hear it. You have to hear it. Hearing it is the mission that is compulsory today. For you to hear it. If you hear it, it will make all the difference in your life. It will make all the difference in your attitude. It will make all the difference in your language and in your lifestyle, in your ministry, in your commitment. It will make all the difference if you can hear it. What we are about is a global vision. From every angle you look at it, it's a global vision. That's what you have been ordained to today. Somebody say, I receive it. Shout it loud, I receive it. Brethren, the earth is the Lord's, and the fullness thereof. And God will use you in the name of Jesus Christ. In scroll number 6, let's not miss the day of God's visitation. Don't miss it, because there are some people who do not know the day of their visitation. We are right now at a time of global favor. The Lord will help us for it to continue. But we don't know whether it will be as easy as this in the future. But we are at a time when the door is so wide open. It's so wide open. That's what God has called you into. He's called you into a great opportunity, a global opportunity. Look, it doesn't matter whether the person beside you is listening to me or not. It's you that I want to listen to me. Listen to what God is telling you. God is telling you that you are a vessel for a global vision, that he is calling you to a global vision, that he needs your commitment to a global vision. That's what God is saying.
Somebody say, I receive it. Say it again, I receive it. Somebody say, I embrace it. Say it loud, I embrace it. And it is so in the name of Jesus Christ. And the Lord God Almighty will help us in this, because he's the Lord of hosts. Let's not miss the day of our visitation. Then in section 2, section B is the commission. What is central to the commission is power. Power is central to the commission. The vision is what you see. The commission is the authority you are given. You are authorized to implement at least part of what you see. So let's think of power. Think of power. Think of today as a turning point for power, as an opportunity for power. Think of today as God placing a demand on power in your life. We are saying the earth is the Lord's. If we are saying the earth is the Lord's, it's not so easy, it's not so simple. The devil is there. The world is there. The flesh is there. That's why we need power. That's why we need power. Brethren, that's why we need power. That was why the Lord Jesus Christ, the last thing he told the disciples as he was about to be taken up, he said, you shall receive. Please say it loud. You shall receive. You shall receive. You shall receive power. Brethren, power, that is the central issue in a commission. That's the central demand of any commission. When God tells you, go and do this, what you need to ask him, Father, the power. Lord, the power. Oh God, the power. That is what is central in this section B. In the commission, the power is what is necessary. The Lord God Almighty will help us and empower us to the extent that we will do what the Lord Jesus has done and do greater works as he has promised in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In scroll number 8, we discover that right from when we are born again, you are born into the characteristics of God. You are born into the nature of God. You are born into the power of God. You are born into the wisdom of God. And you are born to be covered by the glory of God. From whichever angle you look at these things, they have to do with power. The nature of God demands power. You need power to be holy. You need power to live a sanctified life. You need power to walk with God. It is power. Miracles require power. Divine wisdom requires power that is superior to the power of the world. The glory carries the power of God. Power is central to the commission. Today you have been commissioned. This ordination is a commissioning service that God has given to you. The first thing, the last thing, the important thing, the central thing that should consume your heart and your thoughts is power. Somebody say power. Say it again, power. Hallelujah. In scroll number 9, there are the signs of the believers. These signs shall follow them that believe. Being ordained today, take it as something mandatory for you, something compulsory. As I'm ordained today, the signs of the believers must be activated in my life. These signs shall follow them that believe. In my name, they will cast out devils. They will speak with new tongues. They will take up serpents. If they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They will lay their hands on the sick and they shall recover. Make it mandatory in your own life, because power is central to commission. Make it mandatory. If others don't take it serious, let your own business be different. Take it serious. Make it mandatory. Father, let the believer's signs work for me. Let it be activated in my life. And let it be activated in your own life, brethren, in the name of Jesus Christ. In your family, these signs will be made manifest through your life. In your parishes, God will demonstrate his power. In your community, God will show that you are peculiar and that you are a chosen generation, that you are a royal priesthood. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord prove his power in your life. In the name of Jesus. In scroll number 10, I would like to ask you, how many rivers are you carrying? How many rivers are inside you? Every real divine message that comes out of you is a river. Every real inspired song that comes out of you is a river. Different rivers have different strengths, different depths. They flow, they have different lengths. But out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Let the rivers flow in the name of Jesus. Let the rivers flow in the name of Jesus. Let the rivers flow in the name of Jesus. Let the rivers in you cover the whole earth. Let it cover the earth. For the earth is the Lord's. Why should you be limited? Why should you be limited? The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. The earth is the Lord's. Let the rivers in you flow. Let them flow in the name of Jesus. In scroll number 11, let's believe God for greater works. Let's not be contented with what we have seen, with what we have experienced. Let's not be contented with the testimonies we have had so far. There's much ground to possess. There are the works that the Lord Jesus did, and there are greater works. Let's believe God for it. If your neighbor will not, ignore him and believe God. Don't let anybody hinder you. Because it is why people are comparing themselves with themselves and measuring themselves by themselves that they become foolish. Measure yourself with the Lord Jesus Christ. Compare yourself with the Lord Jesus Christ. God chose us that we may conform to the image of his dear Son. He wants us to be like Jesus. May the Almighty God make you like Jesus. Make you like Jesus in nature, and make you like Jesus in power, make you like Jesus in wisdom, and fill you with the glory of the Lord Jesus Christ in the name of Jesus. May the Lord Almighty help you, and may the Lord Almighty help me in the name of Jesus Christ. In scroll number 12, it doesn't matter how empowered you are, it doesn't matter how great your anointing, you will still encounter obstacles. There'll be persecutions. So let's be ready. Let's be ready. Let's not think the whole thing ends at the mountaintop, the Mount of Transfiguration. As you come down there, there is the epileptic boy that is waiting for us. There'll be persecutions. There'll be difficulties. But we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Somebody say, I will overcome. Say it loud. I will overcome. And one more time, I will overcome. The Lord establish you in victory. The Lord of hosts establish you in victory. The God of gods establish you in victory. The Lord of lords establish you in victory. You will overcome. And you have overcome in the name of Jesus. Brethren, we will not fail. We will not falter. We will not diminish. We will flourish. God will help you. On every side, he will help you. The earth is the Lord's. You are a global figure. You will make it. You will make it. You will make it. You will make it. In the name of Jesus. You will make it in the name of Jesus. Section C. This one has got to do with the expansion. If it was left to me, I would just have stopped after talking about power. But the person who has power without wisdom is just like a vehicle that is very powerful and can speed but has no brakes. Very dangerous. Zeal without knowledge is a very terrible thing. And why must we focus on the wisdom? It is the fact that sustainable revivals are the greatest expansion forces. revivals that are sustainable. Nothing expands the kingdom of God like sustainable revivals. And I'm using the word sustainable, sustainable. Expansion that is sustainable. God has helped us in the Redeemed Christian Church of God. God had intervened on a number of things, and you see the hand of God, you see the steps of God making what God is granting to us sustainable. If it is not sustainable, one day it will vanish. But when it is sustainable, it will continue to flourish and flourish and flourish. Your ministry will not diminish. Your ministry will flourish. It will flourish in the name of Jesus. Your ministry will flourish in the name of Jesus. In scroll number 13, it is foolishness that kills revivals. I've read about revivals. I've read many books on revivals. And revivals were usually slowed down and killed by foolishness. Just mere foolishness. There was a time one big organization invited me and asked me to come and speak on how the world can hinder revivals. I told them that the world cannot hinder revivals. But if the world should hinder revivals, the way the world hinders revivals is to become part of it. When the world becomes churchy and the church becomes worldly, then the worldly church welcomes the churchy world, and the church and the world become one together. Then there will be no more revivals. That's the only way the world can stop revivals. Apart from that, the world cannot stop revivals. In fact, the worst that the world can do is to spread it. They persecute the church, they scatter it, and everywhere the saints run to, they run with the revivals. Because when the fire is burning in your heart and burning in your bones, you are unstoppable. Brethren, that is why I say that your ministry will not diminish. Your ministry will flourish. It will flourish. The world will not take an advantage of you. You will break through. You will flourish in the name of Jesus Christ. God will be glorified in your life because He is Lord forever. So scroll 13. Sustainable expansion of the gospel is based on spiritual decency, order, authority, leadership, and cooperative networking. Anything outside of this is foolishness, and foolishness will hinder the work. So I will end up this message by talking about giving us some points of wisdom. But to be able to understand these things more, maybe you should find time to listen to this message maybe a few times over, so that you can get more of the details and go through the pamphlet of the outline that you have. But here are some suggestions that can help you in wisdom so that your work will not diminish. Instead, it will flourish. Number one, beware. That's in scroll 14. Beware. There is Matthew 23. So let's beware. Matthew 23. He said, "Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, hypocrites." Let's beware of hypocrisy. If you want to last with God, if you want sustainable work with God, detach yourself from hypocrisy. Be transparent. You see, when you are transparent, when you are even doing what is wrong and you are transparent, it's easier for us to see and then caution one another and say, "This thing you are doing is not right." But when you are doing that which is wrong and you are covering it and you are appearing to be great, wonderful, tongue-talking, devil-chasing, and so on, we don't know what is wrong unless God shows it by revelations. And at the end, you are the one that is being troubled. You are the one that has problems. So God will help us, because he that covereth his sins, what did the Bible say? He that covereth his sins shall not prosper. But he that confesseth and forsaketh them shall have mercy. May God bring us to the point of mercy, that we may have mercy and obtain mercy in the name of Jesus Christ. So the first thing, let's avoid hypocrisy. And instead of hypocrisy, Let's be open to the Almighty God. Be honest before God and be honest before men. In scroll number 15, the end does not justify the means. The end does not justify the means. If the end could justify the means, then Samuel would have congratulated Saul. God said, Saul, kill, destroy everything in Amalek. He left the best according to his own opinion. And therefore, God said, rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft. To obey is better than sacrifice. The end does not justify the means. It doesn't matter which philosopher has pushed that philosophy. The end does not justify the means. And you can see that in scroll number 15. In scroll number 16, may God help us to energize our system. The Redeemed Christian Church of God has a wonderful system. Every organization has a system. Principles of operation. Principles that should be adhered to in order to keep order and keep decency. May God help us to energize it. A system dies when revelation is lifted. A system dies when divine presence is lifted. That which keeps a system or a tradition going is revelation. It is unction. It is function. When you have unction, when you function by unction, when you function by revelation, then the system keeps going. The system has life. Remove revelation. Remove unction. The system is like body without the spirit. The system dies. But God Almighty, who has chosen the Redeemed Christian Church of God as a global vision, this work will not perish. This work will flourish. It will flourish in your hand. It will flourish in your hand. This work will flourish in your hand. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord will help you and you will succeed. In the system, you will succeed in the name of Jesus Christ. In scroll number 17, brethren, prejudice can be satanic. Prejudice can be satanic. Let Redeemed Christian Church of God never. Thank God for helping us thus far, and God will continue to help us. Let it never, because of you or because of any other person, be seen as a political party. Somebody please say, God forbid. Please say it loud. Let it never be because of you or because of any of us that the Redeemed Christian Church of God is seen as a racist, or even make it lighter, a racial, but racist, terrible, terrible. Prejudice can be satanic. Let it not be because of you that the Redeemed Christian Church of God will ever be seen as a tribalistic church. Everybody is welcome. Please say it. Everybody is welcome to the Redeemed Christian Church of God. Please say it loud now. Let's hear you. Everybody is welcome to RCCG. It's a global vision. And we cannot limit God. Let it never be because of you. Let it never be because of you that somebody will say, oh, it's a political party. It's a tribalistic church. Let it never be because of you. God will help you. And God will help us. In the name of Jesus Christ. Scroll. I nearly jumped now. Well, if God wants me to jump, I will jump. Scroll number 18. Obey and you will be obeyed. If you obey those who are in charge now, you'll be obeyed in future. Look, God is not mocked. Whatever a man sows is what he will reap. If as a deacon, because of that small anointing that comes on you, that small casting out of devils that comes on you, you no longer want to obey the assistant pastor, you don't want to obey the pastor, you don't want to obey the area pastor, one day will be one day. You will be in that position. And whatever you have sown, you will reap it too. It is not a curse. It is a law. I'm not cursing you. I'm just telling you a law. If you want to be obeyed in future, obey those who are in charge now. God will help you to obey in the name of Jesus Christ. Because there has to be order. There has to be decency. In scroll number 19, I want to make this strong statement. No Confucianist is spiritual. There is no Confucianist who is spiritual. Because confusion is carnal. God is not the author of confusion. Anybody causing confusion anywhere is not spiritual. He is carnal. He is fleshly. And if time is not taken, if you watch it well, he might be under demonic influence. God is not the author of confusion. If you find yourself causing confusion, go back and plead with God. Because no Confucianist is spiritual. Every Confucianist is carnal, without exception. If you are a Confucianist, you have already known your standard where you are. But if you are a Confucianist, let it be that you used to be. That from today is a turning point. But there is no Confucianist that is spiritual. We must know that. And it is very clear. Scroll number 20. Be single-minded and wholehearted. Whatever assignment you are given to accomplish, commit yourself to it single-mindedly. The double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Be wholehearted. Don't do it as if there is some you are reserving for the grave, or as if there is some you are reserving for heaven. Do it with all your heart right here. Whatever assignment is committed to you. Let me tell you something you need to know about Daddy. If Daddy tells you plant 60 churches, it is possible. And if you go in by faith, you will find it realized. If you follow the word that is spoken to you and hold on that word, you will find it done. Go forth and do what you have been asked to do. Don't start by complaining. Start by walking. Commit yourself to it. And let God be glorified in your life. In scroll number 21, timidity is not spirituality. Some of us feel that we are very shy. And we think that shyness is spirituality. Timidity is not spirituality. In fact, there is another one that occurred to me as I was praying this morning. That penitence is not a good cover for incompetence. Penitence is not an effective cover for incompetence. The person that is a failure should acknowledge he's a failure and arise and do better. It's not you are a failure. You don't want to work hard. You don't want to accomplish it in. Before they say you have failed, say, I'm sorry. For how long will you keep begging, I'm sorry, and you are not doing what you are sent to do? Penitence is not a cover for incompetence. Scroll number 22. This one now takes us to a special perspective, a special dimension. Let me read scroll number 22. The RCCG cannot, I repeat, cannot win the whole world alone. The RCCG cannot win the whole world alone. If you don't know that, you better know it. There is one body, there is one Lord, there is one God, there is one faith. There is one baptism, there is one heaven, there is one heaven, there is one heaven, there is one body, there is one body, there is one body, there is one body, and every joint supplies that which it has the capacity and the capability to supply. The Redeemed Christian Church of God needs the other parts of the body, as the other parts of the body of Christ need the Redeemed Christian Church of God. Don't you ever get to a point that you start feeling that the Redeemed Christian Church of God can win the world alone. It cannot. It is not possible. That is not how God works. how God works is there is one body that believes in one faith, serving one Lord, enjoying one baptism, heading for one heaven, and we are all members of that one body. And we need to realize it. And we need to embrace those who are of this body, this universal body of the Lord Jesus Christ, so that we can network and accomplish what God has created us for. And in order to emphasize this, I want to put one more advice in verse 23. Not verse 23, in scroll number 23, to buttress this fact of the one body. Maybe I'll read it. Some are isolating from the body of Christ, overstructuring and over administration are major causes of this. What is the solution? What is the solution against overstructuring and over administration? The solution is do your best to be promoted as a result of anointing rather than eye service. That is what we need, brethren. Do your best. Do your best. Hold on God for power. Hold on God for unction. Submit to those who are in authority. But don't serve people because they are looking at you. Serve God. Our primary employer is the Lord God Almighty. He's the one that called you. He's the one that chose you. He's the one that says he will fill you with power. The Lord God Almighty is the one that has brought you into this global vision. This global vision. This global vision. Embrace it. Receive the power for accomplishing it. Let's rise and pray. Let's talk to the Almighty God. Let's talk to Him. I say, Father, thank you for making me part of this global vision. Lord, I thank you. God, I thank you. Father, I thank you for making me part of this global vision. I commit myself to it totally, completely, absolutely. From today, in a special way, I commit myself completely to this global vision. Please talk to the Lord. Talk to the Lord God Almighty. Talk to the Lord God Almighty. Take this ordination as a turning point in your life. Take it as a turning point. Talk to God. Talk to God. Don't let anything disturb you. Talk to God.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Father Almighty, we thank you and bless your name for the reawakening and the renewal of your global vision mandate upon our lives. And Lord, we ask, O God, for renewed grace to go forth with wholehearted commitment unto this mandate, O God, for mightier manifestations in the name of Jesus. We give you all the glory and we bless your name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. We thank Reverend Charles Achonwa for that reawakening and renewal message to the global vision mandate. And we believe, God, that as we go from here, each one of us will go forth with renewed commitment unto the vision for mightier manifestations in the name of Jesus. If you believe you are going forth unto glorious, mightier manifestations, let the Lord hear your amen. Please, let's quickly take this following announcement. We're going on for a long break. And remember, we are all encouraged to take time to pray. By 8 p.m., we'll have the meeting of the workers and the house fellowship leaders. Workers and house fellowship leaders meeting. It's 8 p.m. tonight. And after that, we'll have the council meeting. All those that have been delegated to represent their various parishes would be at the general council meeting. All ushers should please wait at the minister's side of the altar. All the ushers should please wait at the minister's side of the altar for an important information. The Lord bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Can we share the grace together in fellowship? Want to go? The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen.